junction.
Okay, he stopped.
Oh, you know what's going on here? The invisible cop that was in my car for the turn tires mod? He's over there arresting this guy. That's exactly what's happening. This is awesome. It's a Halloween miracle.
All units, all units. Civilians report a suspect armed and dangerous. Please be advised, he's on foot. He's got a firearm attack on an officer. Dispatch a medical team for a drunken disturbance. Attention all units, suspect apprehended.
Hey guys, what is up? Average Guy Gaming here, and welcome back to LCPDFR. Today is Halloween, so this is going to be a Halloween special. I tried coming up with some special ideas to just kind of make this episode different, like a Halloween-themed police car. I tried finding the one that Bay Area Bugs used a while back in his Halloween special, like 2 or 3 years ago. If you guys remember that, if you've ever seen that episode, he made a custom skin that was like a orange police car with a jack-o'-lantern on the side, stuff like that. And it was actually kind of cool, I thought. But anyways, the file is not there, unfortunately. So there's no special police cars or anything. We're just going to make this a Halloween patrol. There's a lot of people out on the street, so and it is getting kind of late in the night. Right now, it is 8:50, about 9 o'clock, so as you can see, it's getting pretty dark outside. I'm also using a new ENB. This is Prophet's ENB, and it's over the top of Cry ENB, so there are certain things that are still there from Cry ENB. Wow, the wall is really bright. That's okay. We'll be outside in just a second. I believe it's probably because of the glare from it being dark outside and bright inside, but that's okay. We're just going to very quickly grab our stuff, grab ourselves a partner. I'm also trying to make this an uncut episode, kind of give you guys the full effect, just since this is a special episode. We'll make it a little bit longer, and hopefully a little bit longer, and give you guys a little bit behind the scene kind of deal here with some of the stuff. Okay, so let's go ahead and get on outside. Yeah, I'm not exactly liking the inside, how bright it is. It looks like that probably is a flaw with the ENB, but that's okay. So we do have some new cars here, San Bernardino Police. And this is CVPI, obviously. We might go ahead and change up the time of day a little bit. I'm not exactly excited about this. Well, it's looking a little bit better now. It's gotten a little darker. Okay, so we have the CVPI. We have the Slick Top CVPI. There we go. It has a steady burn there in the center. Looks pretty good. Do we have a traffic advisor on this one? We just have rear-facing lights. That's cool. I do like that. Then I have this Shelby GT500 Mustang. You know, we might go with this. I don't think you guys have seen an episode with this. I've just kind of played around with it some. I think we're probably going to go with that. Let's see what else I have installed. Honestly, not too sure. Wow, this is so dirty you can't even see the skin. Let's clean it. There we go. San Bernardino again. This is, of course, the Police Interceptor, Ford Police Interceptor. Looks really good, actually. I'm really liking this, and we do have the working takedowns, or spotlights, I should say, on all of these cars. I think the takedowns light up as well. No, we actually don't have takedowns on the light bar, but that's cool. I do like that. And that's pretty much it. We have the Tahoe here. I do love this Tahoe, but I don't think we're going to use it today. We'll probably save that for another day. It has been a while since I've done an SUV, but I'm thinking either this Police Interceptor or the Mustang. I'm thinking we're probably going to go... You know what, let's do it marked at first. Let's do a marked patrol at first here in the Interceptor. And then we'll switch up about halfway in. And we'll go with that Mustang, because that should make for a pretty exciting patrol. So right now we're waiting on our partner to catch up and get in the vehicle with us. I do have a few new mods installed. I believe I have the same siren. Let's find out. Yeah, same siren. Yep, same siren. Okay, so that is cool. Can I turn my siren off? My mouse is not wanting to work. May need to get a new mouse. Some of my mouse buttons aren't working. That's okay. So anyways, we are here in Broker right now. I think we're going to go ahead and relocate. Maybe go... I do want to do a residential area. And I'm trying to think. We could go to West Dyke up here. This area up here, it's a rich, upscale residential area.
We do have, you know, the apartments down here. Could go downtown. We could do that. Or we could go over here in Meadows Park, Meadows Hill area, over in the Willis side of town. I'm thinking we might switch it up and do a few different ones. We'll go over here first. We'll go over here in the Meadows Hill area first. And then we'll probably go downtown after that. We'll use the unmarked Mustang for that. Okay, so we do have a call of armed robbery suspects fleeing. Let's go ahead and take that. I'm going to try to kind of stay away from these calls. Do more. Wow, my siren button on my mouse is not working at all. This kind of is not good for me, but that's okay. Let's see here. I'm trying to focus on what I'm doing, and I'm also a little distracted by the siren not working on my mouse. But that's cool. So we have plenty of units, it looks like. They're actually coming toward us a little bit. Are they on the... Yeah, they're on the highway. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and enter the highway right... where is the entrance to the highway? It's on the next road over. Oh, they got off, didn't they? Yep, they did. Okay, so this is going to be an interesting pursuit. We're already a good bit behind. And I'm not exactly sure how accurate my handling line is because it does not feel too accurate. But they're coming back toward us now. We should see them here in just a moment coming across us here at the cross street. Yep, they're in a van. Yep, there's guys in the back. No shots fired yet. That car's on fire. Yep, they're opening up on us. Alright, so let's, authorize lethal force on these guys. We'll go ahead and have everybody aggressive. Probably about to start firing from the car here. Unfortunately, I don't like to do that. It's not the most realistic. I mean, it does happen, but I mean, you gotta do what you gotta do. And right now, we've got a lot of civilians out here on the street. They're under fire. And yeah, just a lot of people in danger, a lot of officers in danger. Yeah, they're firing officers on the street or civilians, not sure who they're firing at. Alright, let's try this. Oh, get the gun out! Get the gun out! I'm under fire, Alright, we got one down, got two down. Guys are still in the back. Let's try to get them out and get the shotgun out for this. Alright, let's see if we can get them without getting shot. Out of the car, out of the car. Nope, he decided not to listen. I believe there's still one more back there. Let's see if we can order him out through the front. Out of the car right now. Alright, he's not listening. We're going to keep him at gunpoint. Watch our crossfire here if we can. He's pulling him out. Good, 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 good. Oh, gun. Yep, he shot at that officer. I'm not sure if the officer's down. Can't see him here. But we've got... He's still alive. I need to go and call in for EMS and get these guns. Yeah, so I need to take care of this. There we go. Had to do it. Just absolutely had to do it. This is our car here with the siren still on, so we're going to go ahead and probably should get the guns out of these guys' hands first since one of them's still alive anyways. So, interesting start to Halloween night for sure. Yep, one officer is down. EMS has not showed up yet. I'm guessing they're booked, so we're going to go ahead and call for corner. I know that this guy that disappeared, he was dead for good. This guy right here looks like he's still alive. He's probably not going to pull through, though, if I had to take a guess. But I'm not going to say that until coroner gets here and declares him dead. We will try to close down the area first, at least from traffic. Sidewalk people, the pedestrians, they're going to do what they want to do, so I'm not even going to try with them. It's really not worth it. As long as nobody tries to like start a fight with the coroner, I think we'll be good. But right now, this intersection is going to be closed down. Temporarily. Suspect fleeing from FIB near downtown. That's a new call, so we are absolutely going to take it. My siren does not work, I forgot. This is not good. I just realized that. It's the first time I've used this mouse, and it has not worked. The mouse is fine, but for some reason, my side mouse button. I use the Cyborg Gaming Rat 3, I believe it is. It's a older gaming mouse. It's not really older, but it's Oh, yeah. Didn't know he was dead. I should have known something was up when he didn't get out of the car to help. Oh, boy. Sorry. Okay, this is uncut by all means, so we're just going to roll with it, you know? Not much we can do there. Maybe by sometime tonight we're going to get over to our residential area for our Halloween patrol standby, whatever you want to call it. I have a roadblock in place here. Alright, so we're assisting FIB. What is this? Yeah, FIB has our Mustang there that they just wrecked. So this must be a high priority guy. I don't know what the deal is. All I know is we're assisting the FIB on a pursuit. Is he gonna, yep, he's going straight through. Let's authorize lethal force on him. There we go. Alright, maybe they're gonna stop when I get up here. Yeah, we're good. We're out of their sight now, so we shouldn't be fired upon. Fire dual siren, just because we can. Because we don't have any backup as well. We may go ahead and try to use the spikes on this guy. In fact, that's exactly what we're gonna do. We need to get some backup though, for sure. Before we can do that, but see if we can't get ahead of this guy. Go ahead and get the spikes out of the trunk. He's got a lot of speed though right now, so I'm sure nothing's gonna happen right now. There's our pursuit backup. Alright. Grab our spikes. We've got our spikes, okay. So now that we have backup, we can try to get ahead of this guy, cut him off, and deploy our spikes. We're gonna try to go a long way around. Hopefully he's gonna come to us. This is where it gets a little bit tricky because you kind of have to predict where he's going to go, and that's not always the easiest thing, especially when he's got a lot more speed than you do. Oh boy. Yep, I should have seen that coming. Okay, now he's going around this way. He does loop around. There's no other way to get around, so we are going to get ready to throw the spikes. I'll go ahead and toss him out here if he's gonna come. I think they've stopped him. Man, every time I get ready to use the spikes. Oh, okay, that's not good. That was an explosion. Let's see if that was his truck or police car. That was the truck. Where's he at? Oh, he's still running. Does he have a gun? Oh, he has a gun. He's throwing grenades! Oh! He just threw another. Get out of here. Okay. He's throwing grenades right now. I'm just running. Oh. Okay. We're going to have to cheat here. We're going to have to do that because we were about to die. We're going to take cover behind his truck here. Deploy our M4. We're going to say that we had it on our back. Good enough to me because this guy is not going to go down peacefully. Oh, you know who this is? This is the supervillain's call out. That's what this is. Because that is Lewis, I believe, is his name. Yeah, he takes a lot of damage. I did not think about that. We have supervillain's call out installed. So we have some of the story mode characters. And they're pretty tough to take down. They also have some pretty crazy weapons. So yeah, that was Lewis, I believe, is his name. There's also Nico Bellic, I think Roman maybe, and maybe Vlad, I'm not entirely sure, I don't remember. It's been about a couple weeks since I installed the callouts. I've been away for a little bit in case you guys didn't notice, which I'm sure you did. Just had a lot of stuff going on with school, work, and Fire Academy, and let's see, let's go ahead and get our, is it news? Nope, it's going to be FBI. No, you know what, we never did get over here to the residential area, so we're going to do that. What just happened? Whoever this is that just jumped is dead. That's weird. We're going to go unavailable for callouts right now, so just so we can get over here into our area that we've been trying to get for the last, 15 minutes just about. But we have had fun. This has been a pretty exciting, is that the word? Exciting episode so far. We're actually going to pull over and cheat just a little bit here. And skip, let's see, to our area, which I believe is Willis. Dukes. We're over here in Dukes. And we're between a rock and a hard place right now. There we go. All right. So, yeah, we're finally over here ready to patrol. We are not available for callouts. We're going to be assigned to a beat over here and trying to get my speedometer enabled. We will also get our radar enabled. And I think we're going to be good. So we're just going to be watching, safeguarding the pedestrians, making sure nothing crazy is going on here. We have this bus. I don't know what he's doing. We're going to see if he can figure it out. Back it up, dude. Back it up. Okay. Yeah, he's good. Okay. But we're watching traffic, obviously. We're going to be doing our regular stuff. In fact, there's not a lot of pedestrians out right now. What time do we have? Let's see. It is... it does not want to pop up. Let's see. Clock. 21-something-something. So that is, 9 o'clock? Yeah. 9 o'clock on Halloween night. Here we go. We got some people up here. Don't see any trick-or-treaters. Obviously, I don't, I actually did look for, some Halloween trick-or-treater costume pedestrian packs. There's not one for Grand Theft Auto 4, which sucks, because I wanted some of that realism. I wanted something to kind of make this a more realistic Halloween night patrol. But anyways, regardless, hope you guys are having a great night. Hope you guys are having a good Halloween. If you do anything for Halloween, if you're in trick-or-treating or... this guy just ran the red. We have a jaywalker here who just walked out and almost got hit. This is a interesting individual. We're going to actually check him out a little closer. He's wearing a helmet on the sidewalk. Just to me, that seems a little odd, a little out of place. So, we're going to stay right here. We're going to turn our lights off, put our parking lights on. Let's see how it looks. Yeah, it looks really good. If these guys would go around, I'm seeing if he's going to take it off. I don't know if he's just committed a crime and he was using the helmet to conceal his identity or what. But right now, he's, let's see, where's he at over here? He's not on that camera. Okay. He's standing over here. We're just keeping an eye on him. Something about this guy just doesn't seem right to me. Okay, he's going to cross the street. Okay, screaming at this guy in the furnace. Wow, traffic's not yielding to pedestrians, but these guys are just walking right out in the middle of traffic, so I'm really not going to blame traffic for that. Hot and salty. I believe in New York, actually, the stop and frisk law is still a thing, but either way, we're gonna stop him real quick. Jaywalking. And, excuse me there, sir. You. Stop right there. What did I just picked up a piece of trash. You get out of here. You're a clone. I'm not sure what I just threw at him, but I threw something at him. Great. Alright, we're fighting. We're fighting with this dude's, clone. I'm trying to duck the hits, and I'm about to die, actually. We're going to grab a taser out. Taser deployed. Does this guy have a gun? You're trying to fight too, really? Oh, this guy has a gun. Oh, I'm dead. Yep. Wow, Halloween 2016, man. This is rough. Things have really gotten out of hand. So we just woke up and it's already the next day. So guess that's the end of the episode. No, I'm just kidding. We're going to go for another minute here. Let's go ahead and make it nighttime again. It's a little too bright out here for my liking, so we're going to make it night. Let's see. Wow. Let's give the ENB a second here to kick in and adjust.
Because that ain't right. That is not right. I think if we gradually kind of knock it over here in the nighttime, it'll... It's supposed to kick in. Alright, I'm going to give the EMB just a second. Yeah, there we go. There we go. It's adjusting now. And let's check our weather. Maybe change it up here. We'll make it cloudy. Not rainy. Cloudy. Alright. So, let's go ahead and heal ourselves. There we go. And we're going to spawn our nice little unmarked car here and head downtown. So this is gonna be the last part of our episode. We're not gonna go to the West Dyke up here. It's just a little bit too much going on 100 yards. Turn. Everywhere else right now. Well, I don't think we really need to head up there. Alright, so we are now here in Star Junction, Liberty City, downtown, Times Square, whatever you want to call it, works. I guess we're going to be dealing with some traffic. I don't really know. I guess we can make ourselves available for call-outs, and we can just take one we like and ignore the other ones. I wish it were like that in the real world, but, you know, it's whatever. There's EMS that we called for like an hour ago. Actually, 2 days ago. Drunk driver. Should we take that? I mean, that is kind of... Yeah, Halloween. Yeah, you're going to have drunks. Disregard. Okay, we got canceled for it. Which, that's fine. I'm a little salty my mouse is not working, though. There we go, it's kind of working. Okay. Well, I was about to say, the guy over there is kind of flying, but that's a cop, so can't really do anything there. Let's... What are these guys doing? Whoa. Alright, we're gonna follow... We're gonna follow her. Go ahead and flip on my traffic advisor just so the car behind me knows I'm merging in kind of in a non-legit manner. I mean, I'm gonna get behind this lady and find out what her deal is, if she's drunk. Everybody was kind of weaving back there, which the game kind of has that sometimes, like potholes or something, like invisible objects in the road that we can't see but they can see. Now, why is everybody going right? Okay, maybe traffic's gonna figure it out here. We have a traffic jam, as you can see. This is actually the first time I've seen this in GTA 4, to be honest with you. And I'm actually kind of liking it. Like, this is a very realistic thing. Like, cars are stuck in the intersection. Their light has already turned red. Then the next group of cars, their light turns green, and they can't go anywhere. I was about to say, is this dude about to jack my car?
This is control. We've got a criminal fleeing
a crime. No, that's way too far away. We're gonna ignore that. All right. I really don't want to get involved with this, but we really don't have much of an option. Alright, and as soon as we get up here, of course, they fixed it. They're good. So we're going to kind of merge back into where we were. Everybody knows that we're not a... everybody knows that we're a cop now, so the unmarked deal is kind of gone. But we're still going to try to get this woman right here in the red ballista, I think. Fat, screw
pull
it.
Over. Pull over now!
Let's see if she'll pull over for us at this time. She's, I believe, drunk. Oh, are you going to hit this pedestrian? Oh, that's a drunk pedestrian. You know what? This is more legit than a traffic stop for Halloween. We have drunk, so that's a very appropriate thing. We try to shield her with our car while we get out and have a talk with her. Ma'am, stop right there, please. Stop right there. Ah, I forgot how much these drunks suck. Alright, hands up. She's about to wander into traffic, I just know it. But you know what? This is an actual legit thing here. I mean, this is something that would happen all the time on Halloween, I'm sure. Pedestrian just got hit back there. We're going to tell him we're going to respond to that mugging. We got disregarded for it. Not sure what's going on there. Let's ask for the ID of this woman. And then we're going to call for a transport unit. Obviously, I don't have... Great! Okay, you know what? I need backup. I really just need backup here.
I'm going to be
I can't just let her go. Okay, he stopped.
Oh, you know what's going on here?
That's what's going on. The invisible cop that was in my car for the turn tires mod, he's over there arresting this guy. That's exactly what's happening. This is awesome. It's a Halloween miracle. All right, we're gonna call for prisoner transport. I'm actually just gonna throw her in this car right here. Can I? Can she get in this car? If I open the door, maybe? I can't even open the door, can I? That's fine. These guys have got her. We're gonna go look and see if we can find this other dude, which I'm pretty sure this time he's gonna be long gone. Officer down? Yeah, we'll take that. Please let me go. Okay, it is gonna let me respond to this. We're a very rapid response unit here. I mean, we're probably gonna be the quickest unit that we have, just because, I mean, the top speed on this car, acceleration, which acceleration is probably more important than top speed in the city. I mean, I just hit 70 right there, no problem at all. 70 again, weaving in and out of traffic. Okay, coming up on it right here. Here he is. Oh, turn the siren off. There we go. All right. What did it say? Hit E to check his vitals, I think. E? Is it E? Yes, it is. Okay. Wasn't too sure. All right, so this is a new call out. This is not super villains. This is okay, he'll be dealt with soon. Okay, so they're telling me just to leave him here, but to get run over by my car. Thank you. Please make a U-turn. We're safe. Thank you. You know what? There we go. All right, so I'm gonna go look for this car, since that's what they care for me to do more than stay with the officer. So we're gonna do that. I think it's telling me this blip up here, the gray blip. Or is it want me to go to this area? What is the gray blip? Let's find out. That's probably enemy. I really don't know what I'm supposed to do here. We're gonna go to the yellow one just because it's closer, see what it is first. And either way, I mean, it's gonna be a pretty quick drive for either way. I mean, it's gonna be a lot longer, obviously, but let's just see. Hopefully the car we're looking for somewhere down here. Be great. Okay. Yeah, he's not down here, so we're gonna have to make the drive all the way over there to the other side, pretty much. Really, dude? Yeah, it's his twin brother. They're just playing a prank. That's fine. Alright, so we just had confirmation. This guy is over here, apparently, from an officer's ANPR, it said. This is the coroner. Why would I drive? Oh, whoops. I am so confused. You know what? Okay, so this call out glitched. I just drove all the way over here, and this is the coroner's marking, not anybody of importance. So, wait, is he behind the wall? I see a chevron back here. Let's see what this is. Oh, no, that's just the other coroner. So, yeah, this call out is frozen. It's crashed. Either way, I hope you guys have enjoyed this episode. Hope you guys have a nice Halloween. Have fun. Stay safe. Also, feel more than free to leave me a comment below. I'll reply to you. And I will talk to you guys then. I'll see you in the next episode.